Hi everyone. Last time I talked about some chords. Today I'm going to talk about some chords. Let's look at the major scale again. It has one dominant seventh chord built off the fifth degree. It can resolve to the one chord with the third moving up and the seventh moving down. The most important interval to the chord's function is the tritone, in this case a diminished fifth, between those tones. In 12 TET there's only one size of tritone, but in 19 TET there are two. The tritone found between the third and seventh of this dominant chord is the large tritone, 10 steps wide. What happens if we use the small tritone instead? Let's flatten the seventh of the chord one step. We now have what's called a harmonic seventh chord, so called because it better approximates the 4 to 5 to 6 to 7 ratio found in the harmonic series. Built on the fifth degree, it has the notes 5, 7, 2, and flat 4. Resolving to the one chord, the flat 4 is a small semitone, one step above the 3, while the natural 4 is a large or diatonic semitone, two steps above the 3. This change smooths out and strengthens the resolution. One way of setting up this chord is by playing the diatonic dominant chord before it, letting the voice move by small semitones. I mentioned before that 19 TET's wide half steps can make cadences weaker. This is one case where bringing in smaller steps can improve them. The fact that 19 TET has two tritones has another interesting consequence. A tritone substitution normally works by exploiting the fact that the tritone is symmetrical, and thus shared by two dominant chords. The same idea applies in 19 TET, but with a difference. The large tritone inverts to the small tritone, which means that, of the two dominant chords that share a tritone, one of them is a regular dominant chord and the other is a harmonic dominant chord. Since the seventh of the starting chord is the third of the tritone sub, moving the seventh of the starting chord moves the third of the tritone sub, which thus moves the root. If you take the progression from earlier and replace the dominant chords with their tritone subs, you get this equivalent progression. Another way of shrinking the tritone is to raise the third of the dominant chord instead, tightly approaching the root of the target chord. Because it's not built off a major chord anymore, I don't consider it a basic dominant type. It's a more dissonant sound, but it's an option to keep in mind. That raises a question. What if you did both? Raising the third and lowering the seventh tightly surrounds the target major third on both sides. Something odd's happened, though. Let's look at that tritone again. By reducing the tritone twice, it's become a perfect fourth. This produces a chord far outside what you would hear in 12 TET. Surprisingly, it still works as a dominant chord despite the tritone being altered out. You can even voice it quintally by putting the third above the seventh. But can you tritone substitute a chord with no tritone? Well, kind of. The perfect fourth in the harmonic seventh sharp 3 chord inverts to a perfect fifth, so the chord's tritone sub isn't a dominant chord at all. It's a regular major or minor seventh chord, depending on which tritone you move the root by. You can substitute this progression with this, or use both subs of the H7 sharp 3 to get this. What's cool about this is that we started by modifying dominant chords, but we ended up not using any of them. In general, starting from what you already know, then exploiting the differences of the new system is a good way to get fresh ideas. Of course, starting from scratch can be valuable, but you may not have a way to relate what you find to what you had before. I started this video with the fact that 19 TET has two different tritones. This comes from the fact that nothing in 19 TET is symmetrical. Next time, I'm going to explore some other implications of that feature.